Hollywood, we present the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show. Brought to you by Anacin for fast relief from pain of headache, neuritis, and neuralgia. Dentine, the gum with breathtaking flavor, and Beeman's Pepsin, the gum that's great to chew and good for your digestion, too. And by Chesterfield. Sound off for Chesterfield. Get something new, something no other cigarette has. Chesterfield mildness plus no unpleasant aftertaste. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to introduce our master of ceremonies.
Hiya, folks. This is Dean Martin. Well, 1951 has been put away for all time, and here we are about to swing into our first show for 52. But before we start, I've received a lot of letters asking me if my partner Jerry Lewis is as nutty offstage as he is on. Well, I'd like to answer that question once and for all. It may surprise you, but there are really two Jerry Lewis's. And believe me, both of them are idiots. So, to get away from the animal for a while, suppose we do a little meandering.
I went meandering to find myself a wife, a pretty miss to share my kiss and love me all my life. The lonely bachelor's life I led began to get me down. I bought a ring and everything and went right into town. I went
meandering, meandering, looking far and wide for a girl to be my bride. Meandering, meandering,
far from the old folks at home. I came across a pretty girl who said she loved me so, that she would bring her mother with us everywhere we'd go. I was so happy on the day she said she'd be my wife, but when she told me that her ma would live with us for life, I went
meandering, meandering, looking far and wide for a girl to be my bride. Meandering, meandering,
far from the old folks at home. Finally found myself a wife, a gal who's sweet and true. When I am tempted to do something that I shouldn't do, then I remember days when things were not like they are now. I recall when I was just a bachelor and how I went meandering, meandering, looking far and wide for a girl to be my bride. I went meandering, meandering, far from the old folks at home.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. And now, it gives me... Why are you so upset?
Why am I upset? I can't find my head.
But you've got it on. It's that round thing on your shoulder.
You sure that's my head?
Yes.
Good heavens, that means I've lost my bowling ball.
Jerry. Now, once and for all, what makes you act like such an idiot?
Well, you know, that's a good question. I guess I act like an idiot for three reasons. First, I like to hear people laugh. Second, I'm an easygoing guy that thinks of nothing but fun, joy, and happiness.
And third?
I'm an idiot.
Now, Jerry, have a heart.
No, thanks. I got one, but maybe you have an extra kidney.
Now, listen, I've had enough of this, and
You're getting angry, and if you continue to get furious, I'm afraid I'll have to let your secret out of the bag.
Now, what secret? I'm not afraid of anything you may say.
All righty. Ladies and gentlemen, Dean Martin puts chicken fat in his hair.
I do not.
So how come this morning in the bowl there was a ring of feathers?
Anyway, you're a fine one to talk about appearance. Why, just look at you. I've never seen anyone so unkempt.
That's a lie. I may be a little sloppy, but nobody can say I ain't kempt.
Well, I...
If there's one thing I watch, it's my kempness.
All right. Anything. You're not unkempt. You're immaculate. Perfectly immaculate. I never knew a man so neat and so tidy.
Okay. I'm a slob and you know it.
Now, look, Jer, let's drop this foolish bickering.
That suits me fine. Besides, we should stick together for the coming emergency.
Emergency? What emergency?
You mean you ain't right? The country's being invaded by midgets.
Country's being invaded by midgets?
Sure, it's all over town. The shrimp boats are coming.
Oh, shut up. Jerry, the shrimp boats are coming is the title of a song, and besides, shrimps are really fish.
Yeah, then what's Mickey Rooney, a large lobster?
Aren't you ever going to stop twisting what I say, Shirley?
Not as long as we get laughs with him, Selma. Selma?
I suppose you have a point there, Jerry. Yeah, you may have a point there. Oh, you're a good boy. Before we go too far ahead, who's our first guest for tonight?
Beats me. I didn't ask anyone to come over.
Well, in that case, I have an old dramatic tune here, and I might as well sing it.
Yeah. No, it ain't funny. I don't think it's fair, you, Dean. You ain't supposed to sing now. This is where we work as a team together both.
I know what. Why don't you follow me as I sing the words and join in when you get to Ergy? The Ergy. Ergy. Oh,
she's only a bird in a gilded cage.
Couldn't find an apartment.
A pitiful sight to see.
I can see her now, hanging all day from her toes, eating matzo meal.
You may think that she's happy and free from care.
It's just a shallow mockery. I tell you, that bird is just tweeting to hide a broken heart. I'll never Oh, don't laugh. I'll never forget the time I threw her a worm and she cried until her red breast was just a pale pink.
She is not, though she seems to be.
Look how she pretends. Oh, how brave can a sparrow be?
You're sad when you think of her wasted life.
Well, she had a chance to fly away with an eagle, but she blew it. Turned him down for an old woodpecker.
But youth cannot mate with age.
At 61, a woodpecker ain't no chicken.
She sold her soul.
Well, no wonder the way he courted her, why the old bird took her to every statue in town.
Where an old man's gold.
Why do birds insist that money is everything?
He's a bird in a gilded cage.
Unhappy birdie, she's a bird in a gilded cage.
Well, you know, ladies and gentlemen, one of the greatest thrills for a singer is to introduce brand new songs to the public. Our new picture, Sailor Beware, gives me that opportunity. One of those songs in it has fast become a favorite of mine, and I hope you like it too. So, maestro.
Never before has my heart felt a thrill like this. Never before. Never before. Never before has the whole world stood still like this. As I gaze at the face I simply adore. After today, when they speak about paradise, I'll smile and I'll say, I've been there once or twice. For this or that once in a lifetime, the miracle of your kiss. I've never loved like this, never before. For this is that once in a lifetime, the miracle of your kiss. I've never loved like this, never
gentlemen, the time has come to add a note of glamour to the program, which brings me to the happy task of introducing our guest. She is one of Hollywood's fastest rising favorites, the lovely and talented Miss Mona Freeman.
Thank you, folks. And thank you, Jerry.
Thank you, Jerry. Oh, Mona, you're a confused girl.
You mean you're not Jerry Lewis?
No, you're Jerry. Sure, I'm not Jerry Lewis. I have enough trouble being Dean Martin.
Oh, gosh, I'm sorry. But over the phone, I was told that Jerry was tall and handsome with curly hair and, well, you're awfully pretty, so naturally I...
You were told that Jerry was tall and handsome and curly hair? Mm-hmm. Who told you that?
I did.
Jerry, how could you tell Miss Freeman all those lies?
Well, she asked what I was like, and I got carried away.
Pardon me, Dean, but I think your partner is a J-E-R-K.
I heard that, lady. Who's Jack?
Jerry, don't you know enough not to raise your voice in a lady's presence?
That's right, Germ. Remember. Well, we're talking to a girl.
What's so special about girls? Girls are nothing but a rag, a bone, and a hank of hair. What's that other stuff you got there?
Jerry, Mona is a big picture star.
Haven't you ever seen any of my pictures, Jerry?
No, I didn't even know they were back from the drugstore. Oh, I'm not well.
Jerry, I think you've annoyed Mona enough for one night, and I don't know why you're so distrustful and mean.
I'm sorry, Mona. I wasn't always this way, honest. I used to be a sweet, trusting boy, the kind that wouldn't hurt a flea. And then one day, I was betrayed by someone very close to me.
You mean?
Yeah. The flea bit me.
No, really, enough is enough. Say, Dean, what kind of a play are we going to do tonight?
Well, I thought we'd get serious and try something in the educational line. So we're going up Alaska Way to do a real-life Eskimo scene.
Well, that sounds like fun. When do we leave?
By the time Jimmy Wallington gets through, I imagine we'll be there.
Ladies and gentlemen, we know less about our northern neighbors, the Eskimos, than we do about most other people. So tonight, at long last, you will learn the truth about these great people of the frozen north. We are proud to present Dean Martin, Jerry Lewis, and Mona Freeman in that stirring drama, Nanook the Schnook. Our scene is a lonesome little igloo in the cold, windswept Arctic. And there, primitive and wild, we find the beautiful Eskimo girl, Nick Nack, and her husband, the mighty hunter, Nanook the Schnook.
Me, Nick Nack. Me, Eskimo girl.
Me, Nanook. Me, Eskimo girl.
Hey, you not Eskimo girl. You Eskimo boy.
Oh, Me wear fur coat so long, me forget.
Me very smart, Eskimo.
Let them laugh.
Oh. I wish I were dead. Me very smart, Eskimo.
I'm Jikey.
Yeah.
Knick-knack.
What we eat tonight?
Tonight is roast penguin.
Roast penguin? It's always roast penguin.
Every time I eat penguin, I feel like I'm eating a head waiter.
me hear dog.
I, me, both of us hear dog.
Must be someone coming. Me go look see. It's stranger from California.
How you know he's from California?
Dog sled has white sidewalks. Come in, stranger. You're welcome.
Pardon me, sir and madam. I've been traveling for many hours and stopped here only for a moment's shelter against the cold. You sure have a lovely place here. Do you have to defrost it often?
Ha, ha, ha. Stranger, make big funny. Make everybody laugh. Ha, ha, ha. Don't do it no more.
Tell me, Nanook, how does it feel to live up here in the frozen snow?
Well, every day, me get up and go out in big cold. Me walk many miles over beautiful, clean ice. Me breathe clean, cold air all the time. When me come home at night, me walk into nice, cold igloo. Take deep breath and say,
Nanook, maybe stranger hungry after a long trip.
Hey, you want my homemade Eskimo pie?
Your homemade Eskimo pie? Well, what's that?
It's a walrus tongue on a stick.
No, thank you.
But it's very good. When you lick it, it licks back.
By the way, I understand that you Eskimos have a strange way of kissing.
What's strange? We rub noses.
Well, in America, we kiss on the lips. Why do you rub noses?
Here, nights are 6 months long, so we rub noses. It's slower that way.
Nanook, you schnook, you mind if I rub noses with your wife?
Sure. No skin off my nose.
You're right. Nanook is a real schnook. Come, stranger, we rub noses. Well, how you like?
None bad at all.
If he knew about this 4 years ago, he could have saved the surgery.
Get out.
Well, we've had a number of requests to repeat a song we did on an earlier show. It's a song that's kind of close to Jerry and me because we heard it at a mighty important moment over 5 years ago. We were sitting in a small club talking over our dreams and hopes for the future. Neither one of us setting the world on fire. My singing just about kept me in coffee and cigarettes. And Jerry's record act just about kept him in milk and funny books. Suddenly, we decided to try our luck as a team. And it always seemed symbolic that as we shook hands, the band was playing.
You may not be an angel, 'cause angels are so few. But until the day that one comes along, I'll string along with you. I'm looking for an angel to sing my love song to. And until the day that one comes along, I'll sing my song to you. for every little fault that you have. Say, I got three or four. The human little fault that you do have. Just make me love you more. You may not be an angel, but still I'm sure you'll do. So until that day that one comes along, I'll string along with you. For every little fault that you have, say I've got three or four. The human little faults you do have, just make me love you more and more. You may not be but still I'm sure you're gonna do. So until that day that one comes along, I'll string along with you.
String along with you.
Strings break too easy, and I don't want to lose you, Bubby.
Say, boys, do you mind if I cut in for a fast good night?
Hey, Moni, how about you and me getting together at my place for dinner, just us two, huh, Moni?
Oh, that'd be a pleasure, Jerry.
Uh-oh. Now I've done it. I'm not even hungry.
Oh, stop it, Jerry. You know, Mona, we certainly enjoyed your company tonight.
Yeah, Mona, you're all right in my book.
Oh, it was my pleasure, boys. I really enjoyed every minute of it.
You like us?
I think you're the funniest team in show business. And as far as I'm concerned, well, I'd be your guest on your show anytime you'd want me. Why, I can't ever recall having so much fun on a radio show. So where's the money?
Well, this wraps up another one, so until we meet again, this is Dean Martin.
And Jerry Lewis reminding you that we appear on radio through the courtesy of Hal Wallace Productions, producers of our new picture, Sailor Beware.
Good night, everybody.
Night, everybody.
God bless.
From Hollywood, you have just heard transcribed the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show, written by Ed Simmons and Norman Lear, produced and directed by Dick Beck, with music under the direction of Dick Stabile. Brought to you by Anison for fast relief from pain of headache, neuritis, and neuralgia. By Dentine, the gum with breathtaking flavor. By Beeman's Pepsin, the gum that's great to chew and great for your digestion, too. And Chesterfield. Sound off for Chesterfield. Get something new, something no other cigarette has. Chesterfield's mildness plus no unpleasant aftertaste. Mona Freeman can currently be seen in the Paramount picture, Darling, How Could You?